all of the evidence there is proved to be true, I would not employ Mr. Lawson, because I would not employ any proven or admitted communist, because they're just a disruptive force. I don't want them around.
They could be a disruptive force within the motion picture industry. Isn't that true?
Well, of course.
Then don't you think this committee has an obligation to expose them if they are there?
I've always said that you did, but I've always thought that you should do it under the American program of a free and fair trial. I have never objected to your investigating Hollywood. I told you that we welcomed it, and we sincerely do. We haven't always welcomed some of the methods that you have adopted. You've said, and it's the kind of a statement that I'm very happy to hear a member of the committee make, because it's the type of a statement which is a truly American statement. But perhaps you were misinformed about some angles of it. May I suggest to you that, for instance, when I was on the stand here in March, I was asked over and over again, and the testimony is here before me, why we hadn't made anti-communist pictures, and what were we going to do about making them? I tried to reply, Mr. McDowell, at that time, I tried to say that this industry was before a congressional committee in the early 40s, because they said we were warmongering. We don't want to be called again before an investigation, congressional investigating committee, and be called warmongering. Furthermore, Mr. McDowell, the questions asked me repeatedly, and the questions asked repeatedly from witnesses during this present investigation, have indicated, are you making anti-communist pictures, and why don't you make them? Now, we feel that that is the duty and responsibility of the producer, just as is the duty and the responsibility of the publisher, Mr. McDowell, to determine what goes in his newspapers.
I agree.
I think you agree to that.
I agree with you, Mr. Johnson. I'd like to point out to you.
We welcomed an investigation in Hollywood, and we certainly think it's warranted.
I'm glad to hear you say that.
The thing that perturbs me, Mr. Vail, is, for instance, you had a Mr. Howard Rushmore here to testify. I think you had complete confidence in his integrity. He was a former admitted communist, but had seen the error of his ways, like the Bible says, and had reformed.
May I, will you yield to me right there?
Yeah.
We had...
To the effect that we have no responsibility for the political or economic views of any particular individual, but we do have a responsibility for what goes on the screen.
Right.
We guard that with great care. you're aware, I presume, of the fact that throughout this country, in a great many municipalities, we have moving picture censor boards set up by those municipalities.
Based on hate. And the history of the world shows that that's never successful. The fascist party was overthrown because it was based on hate. The communist party is based on hate. The class struggle. And I don't think the communist party can succeed either yet, Mr. Vail. And certainly I think it is the duty of Congress to point out to the American people the dangers. And I think it's the duty of Congress to determine whether these people are foreign agents or not, and if so, are they attempting to disrupt our government by unconstitutional means? We feel that there is very little, if any, communist propaganda in our pictures. Please bear in mind that we are doing business in a worldwide basis. And when you hurt us, you hurt our pocketbook worldwide, and you hurt the American nation worldwide, too. Because the best conveyor of goodwill between our nation and other nations, in my opinion, is the American motion picture. A picture is worth 10,000 words, as the old Chinese proverb goes. In many of these countries, our newspapers do not reach, our radio cannot reach, but they have an idea of America from American motion pictures. We don't want the feeling to go out to these countries that American motion pictures contain communist propaganda and that they will be excluded from these areas. It would be bad for us financially. We think it would be bad for the American people and bad for peace of the world if that went out. We do not attempt or in any way, I have not attempted to in any way criticize the members of the committee. We feel and that you're doing a job which has to be done. We have criticized sometimes, Mr. Vail, the method in which it was done, because we feel that people should not be smeared with communism unless they have a fair trial and opportunity of proving whether they are or not. Now, that's the American tradition, Mr. Vail.
I appreciate that.
Very good.